Did you know that vitamin B12 levels and sunlight are related? Could our modern industrialized societies be causing our vitamin B12 deficiencies? Well, in this video, I will tell you what you need to know about vitamin B12. If you have questions and comments, please leave them below. I would love to hear from you. I'm Dr. Janine Bowring, naturopathic doctor and best-selling author. So what you need to know about vitamin B12? Well, it's called cobalamins because it is bound to cobalt, and cobalt is a trace element that needs strong stomach acid in order for it to become unbound from the proteins that it's bound with. There's different types of B12, so you may have heard of methylcobalamin, adenosylcobalamin, and my least favorite is cyanocobalamin, and I'm going to get to that in just a second, but you can imagine, I want you to think about it. What could that be? Cyanocobalamin. But the body doesn't make vitamin B12, and that's why we rely on getting B12 from the outside, so from our diet. And this is why typically vegetarians have a very difficult time getting enough B12, because it's something that's produced by microorganisms. And once those are ingested by the animals, then that's how we get it when we eat the animals. So it's something that is grown in the digestive tracts of animals who are consuming these elements. So the cyanocobalamin, I promised I would come back to. Now, did you figure out what it is? Well, it's cyanide plus cobalamin. And that's why I have such an issue when we talk about supplementation. Cyanocobalamin is probably the most commonly prescribed and used and purchased type of vitamin B12 supplement, but it's bound to cyanide. And the reason why this is concerning is because it needs four stages of breakdown in our body when we take that type of B12. And at every stage of that breakdown of the cyanocobalamin, trace amounts of cyanide are being released into our body. So how good can that be? In my opinion, not the best thing. So what's interesting as well is that for cyanide poisoning, so if you are in an Alfred Hitchcock scenario and you've been poisoned by cyanide, well, what they would do in emergency medicine is to give you an IV of methylcobalamin. So because we know that the cobalamin will grab up that cyanide. So not the best situation when you're actually taking it in a supplement form. I tend to like the adenosylcobalamin. This is my favorite, and this is the type of B12 that I take when I am supplementing with vitamin B12. It's rapidly absorbed, and the adenosylcobalamin goes right into the mitochondria, and this is to produce the energy in our cells. It has a lot to do with the Krebs cycle and producing that ATP for our vital energy. And when we talk about different types of supplementation, the adenosylcobalamin is great because it gets right into the mitochondria. It bypasses any difficulty that we may have in terms of digestion and absorption of B12, which is common if we're in that low acid state, so we don't have enough stomach acid to break it down. And for people who have pernicious anemia, which is an autoimmune condition in which you don't have enough intrinsic factor, and when you're lacking in intrinsic factor, that B12 cannot be well absorbed into the digestive tract. Now, here's what you probably haven't heard about vitamin B12. B12 is actually a photoreceptor. So this is important. I won't get into the itty-bitty details here, but it's important that sunlight and water both help with our energy production in the mitochondria, and B12 has a lot to do with this. Now, unfortunately, because of our modern life, because of EMF exposure and EMR, so from 5G, and Wi-Fi and all of these things that are devices that we inundate our bodies with, plus the blue light wavelength. So that's again from our devices, that if we're not protecting ourselves from this blue light, especially at nighttime, which is the worst time as it offsets all of our circadian rhythms. This is something that I talk about at length in other videos, so check that out. But it also messes up our B12 metabolism, and B12 is meant to recycle in our body through our liver. So we can mess all of this up by having too much of that non-native EMFs and that blue light. So thanks for joining me today. And if you've got questions and comments, please leave them below. If you learned something new or you think this will help somebody else to learn about B12, please share this video. Please give me a big thumbs up as well. I really appreciate it. And make sure that you're subscribed if you haven't yet done that. Remember to take good care of your health and to do it naturally. Thanks for watching.